One in every 200 people alive today is a victim of modern slavery. We see the highest rate is thought to be in Africa and Asia Pacific.
152 million kids around the world are in child labour.
$150 billion a year is made from forced labour. And one of the key places we need to look is at brick kilns, identified through satellite imagery. Not every brick kiln is a site of modern slavery or forced labour or debt bondage, but you're much more likely to be in forced labour if you work at a brick kiln than if you work in some other worksite. This is a visualization of urbanization. Those cities are a giant magnet for often unskilled laborers being put to work on construction sites. They're vulnerable to exploitation by corrupt labor brokers. Around 1.8 million cases of forced labor arise in agriculture and fisheries. This is a representation of all of the countries that in recent years have had their access to European markets questioned formally, interrogated, or even suspended as a result of European concerns about the kinds of illegality we've been talking about. Now, concerns recently led the largest pension fund in the world, Norway's, worth $1 trillion, to divest from 33 companies involved in palm oil. And just last week, Citibank divested from the second largest food company in Indonesia over concerns around labor irregularities.
So we see governments doing a number of things now. They're bringing in legislation to require companies to identify, report on, and address these issues in their own supply chains.
Investments coming from those jurisdictions into Asia Pacific will increasingly have to focus on these risks. Exports from Asia Pacific will be affected by buyers asking these questions. Here we have a visual representation of the 88 stock exchanges that have joined the United Nations Sustainable Stock Exchange Initiative. Many of them are from Asia Pacific. Governments have also been joining the call to action to end forced labour, modern slavery and human trafficking, a set of commitments to take action, often in partnership with business, to address these risks. 85 countries have joined this call. So this is a representation of those governments that have been taking action in their public procurement processes to find and address modern slavery and forced labour risks. A country gets lighter as it takes more action. So notice how China lights up there.
We're also seeing business recognize this isn't just about costs or risks, there's opportunity here. One example is in financial exclusion. It's a major driver of modern slavery.
There are still 1.7 billion people alive today who don't have access to a formal financial institutional account, and to credit in particular. If you're poor and you suffer a sudden financial shock, your lack of access to credit can force you to sell labor in a risky way that can lead you into forced labor or human trafficking. Now we have ways of assessing creditworthiness that don't require us to look for people having access to land or other property. We can look at their smartphones. We can look at their online behavior to reliably assess their propensity to pay. So there's a commercial opportunity here to bring those services to populations that are highly vulnerable to forced labor and modern slavery in a way that represents a profit opportunity, but also is good for people. We need business champions here in Asia Pacific to help end modern slavery by 2030.